Hi everyone! In this video, I will walk you through animating a MetaHuman in sequencer with control rig. I have a new level sequence here and our MetaHuman blueprint already added to the scene. All what we have to do is go to track, actor to sequencer, and choose our blueprint. You can as well drag and drop the MetaHuman blueprint directly to sequencer. In both cases, you should see the control rig tracks added dynamically there. This is because we have a new default animation rig property on the skeletal meshes. This property would allow sequencer to add the default control rigs associated with the skeletal meshes automatically for you. We have a very detailed video going over the face control board and its amazing features. So in this video, I will demonstrate mostly on the body control rig. However, all concepts shown here are applicable to any control rig in Unreal Engine. The rig itself is quite simple, and many of you will probably find it similar to other rigs you may have used before. Once you add a control rig to sequencer, you should see a controls and an animation panel on the left side. The controls act as a control rig outliner where you can see all of the rig controls, select them, and see their channels displayed here. The animation panel has general settings that apply to every control rig you have in the level. We can display the hierarchy, spaces, and show and hide manipulators. These two options are not relevant anymore, so we can skip these. Chord system per widget mode allows you to have a different coordinate space per transform gizmo. For example, here I have world space associated with the translation and local space with rotation. If I turn off this option, if I go back now to translation, you will see it is local space or the same space as the last selected transform gizmo. Only select rig controls is a very useful option, and I highly recommend enabling that when animating in sequencer. Local transforms in each local space would allow you to transform multiple selected objects in their own local space. To demonstrate that real quickly, by default, the second selected object will transform in the local space of the first selected object. And you can see that clearly on the rig because we have actually a mirror behavior on the rig. So the correct behavior for the rig would be like this when this option is on. So I also recommend enabling this option when working with the MetaHuman rig. Gizmo scale is pretty self-explanatory and it can come in real handy when animating with multiple controls close to each other. With all of this info out of the way, let's start animating in sequencer. For even better accessibility and more selection options, you can use our MetaHuman control rig picker. You can find it in the sample MetaHuman folder under the common utilities. Just run the widget, select the actor, and you are ready to go. There are extra options here, like selecting all of the finger controls, showing and hiding the body controls, and switching IK and FK. You can also switch all of the limbs IK and FK mode on the global control from the controls panel or in sequencer. I will try and keep our animation experiment here really simple and just create an arm wave. I'll start by making sure that I have only select rig controls option on, and with Control Alt drag, select all of the body controls and add a keyframe by pressing S in sequencer. Now in FKR mode, I will select the upper arm, twist, lower arm, select all arm controls and add a keyframe. I can switch to IK mode in the MetaHuman control rig picker or in the channels on the left side or in sequencer. It is placed on the global controller. I will just switch it here in sequencer. That will add a keyframe on all of our arm controls, both IKFK, so they snap in place. After a few frames, I will just try create a wave. If you are interested in learning more about control rig and backward solve, make sure to check out our control rig team talks on Unreal Engine Learning channel. We have two options to bake to skeletal animation. You can choose to bake animation sequence, and you can choose to create a linked animation sequence. Linked animation sequence will make this track own the newly exported animation. Let's try this quick. I will save the animation in the MetaHuman 01 animations folder, name it MetaHuman Wave, and create. If I close sequencer and go to our animation, you will see we have the new animation exported here. If I open the animation in the edit in sequencer, it should give us the option to open the level sequence where this animation was created or baked in. Now it is open and we have the animation on the control rig still here. So what if you have a skeletal animation that wasn't created using a control rig? We have the ability to retarget skeletal animations on a control rig thanks to backward solve graph. This one really opens the opportunity for different configurations of how you would like to retarget your skeletal animations on the control rig. To demonstrate this, I will use a much better animation this time. We'll start with deleting the MetaHuman control rig. Just need to go back to the default pose. Delete. Add an animation track, and I will look for the ROM animation we have. Okay, this is obviously a much, much better animation than our wave. So in order to bake this, right mouse click on the body, bake to control rig, and we have our MetaHuman control rig. It will take a couple of minutes. I want it to be one-to-one, so I will disable reduce keys. Now we have the animation retargeted on our control rig. Which is really great. If you would like to edit on top of this, you can either edit the curves in the curve editor, or you can as well add an additive animation track. You will not need to do this step in the future, but for now, you need to make sure all of the bool values are set to the default values in the additive layer to how they are on the rig. For example, the arm L FK IK switch is off by default, and the legs IKFK switch are on by default. There are also a couple of other values on the FK arm to set to local space and the head as well. Now if we scrub through the additive layer, you will see we have the expected behavior. Let's make her bend a little bit more in here. So in this case, we would select all the spine controls. Key this section. And go. A little bit more here. Press S. And a little bit more here. And press S. Let's fix this small intersection with the hands and the pants. I will select the FK arm control add a keyframe here. And here. And in between, I will just rotate the hand up a little bit. And there you go. This is probably the easiest way to work with baked animation in Sequencer, and it is quite effective. This wraps up our video. I really hope you like it, and we are all really looking forward to your animations in Engine. Thank you.